we have got two expression, B is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi 2m, again this and this are vector quantities, upon x cube. And another here, B is equal to mu naught m upon 4 pi x cube. So these are two cases. First case, when the point is somewhere on the axis of this loop. Another case, when point is somewhere just above the this loop. If we contain this loop in a plane and this point is somewhere in this plane. So second case is this one, plane case, and first case is the axis case. So these are the cases. So these type of magnetic fields we have calculated for this current loop, circular current loop. And when these results will become exact, when r is equal to 0, that means this loop will become a point. The results obtained above can be shown to apply any planar loop. So here we have solved for circular loop, but any planar loop, whether it is a rectangular loop, so we can solve for this as well. A planar current loop is equivalent to a magnetic dipole of magnetic moment M is equal to IA. What we will change, so here the area was pi r square. For this rectangular loop, area is simply equal to A into B, where A and B are the lengths of the side. So that is the only thing that will change. The area will change, other things will remain same. Only thing, we will use area in calculating this M. So we have shown a current loop produces a magnetic field. So figure 4.12, so that we have already seen where this diagram was shown. Figure 4.12, where this diagram was shown. So please look at figure 4.12. This kind of figure was there and behaves like a magnetic large dipole at large distances. So what we have seen, this current loop produces a magnetic field and at large distances behave like a magnetic dipole. So previously we have seen electric dipoles and now we have magnetic dipole. So previously we saw that this current loop is producing some magnetic field, now it is behaving like a magnetic dipole, because we have seen similar equations for electric dipole. Here we are seeing the similar equation for magnetic dipole. Second thing about this circular current loop is subject to torque like a magnetic needle. So it is also subject to a torque like a magnetic needle. Suppose this is the magnetic field. This is the magnetic field and this is your magnetic needle. Let us say this is our magnetic needle. So if we put this magnetic needle in this field, so what will happen? It will try to rotate itself in the direction of the magnetic field. It will rotate in the direction of the magnetic field. So what is the force? Force will definitely be zero. There will be a torque. So this circular current loop is also a subject to torque like the magnetic needle. Let us read this statement. So this will help in understanding the next topics much better. So these two discovery, that this will behave like a magnetic dipole and is a subject to torque like a magnetic needle, this led Ampere, scientist Ampere, to suggest that all magnetism is due to circular currents. So now we know that all the magnetism is due to circular currents that produce the magnetic field. So if you see this circular current loop, so what would be the direction of the magnetic field? That you can calculate from the right hand rule. So since current is moving in this direction, so direction of the magnetic field is this. this seem to be partly true. So what he assumed that all the magnetism is due to circulating currents. This seem to partly true, and no magnetic monopoles have been seen so far. Why it is true? Because if you see this electric field, so there is a positive charge, there is a negative charge. Magnetic field lines start from positive charge and will end at negative charge. So this is the origin, sorry, this is not magnetic, electric field lines. Electric field lines start from positive charge and will end at negative charge. So this is we saw. So it starts, it originates from positive charge and end at negative charge. But till now we have not found something north and something south. That something is producing some magnetic field which is going from north to south. This kind of thing has not been found till yet. So what is correct? There are always current circulating loops. This seems to be partly true, and no magnetic monopoles have been seen so far. Magnetic monopoles are N and S. Till now there is nothing found which has only N type of magnetism or which has only S type of magnetism. But we know there is positive charge and negative charge separately. But in a magnet, there is always north and south side together. There are no separation. However, elementary particles such as electron or a proton carry an intrinsic magnetic moment. So how do these elementary particles produce magnetism? They carry an intrinsic magnetic moment. So magnetic moment here was M. So this is for the current loop. But these elementary particles also carry some intrinsic magnetic moment not accounted by circulating currents. So that's why there is partly word is used, because partly true, because all the other things are due to magnetism is due to circulating the current. But for small particle like electron and proton, they carry some intrinsic magnetic moment which you cannot say that because of the circulating currents. So now let us see the next topic, the magnetic dipole moment of a revolving electron. So this is also a very important topic, that what is that magnetic dipole moment of a revolving electron. So till now you know quantum numbers n, principal quantum number 1, 2, 3 and so on. And next quantum number is L, which is called, this is called principal quantum number. This is azimuthal quantum number. So this is 0, 1, 2, up to this N minus 1. Then you have this M, third quantum number, ML or M sometimes. So this is minus 2 plus L including zeros, like minus 2, minus 1, then 0, plus 1 and plus 2, this type of numbers. And last quantum number is spin quantum number, either it is shown by S or MS. So I am showing it by MS, this is by ML. So this is plus half or minus half. So these are four quantum numbers. So remember these things. So we are going to see the effect of these quantum numbers in the next part. So from Bohr's theory, we have this kind of model where there is a positively charged nucleus. The electron is revolving around this positively charged nucleus. So here you can see the electron is moving in this direction, and the magnetic field is shown as cross. Magnetic field is shown as cross. So that means magnetic field is going inside the plane of paper, and the distance of the center of this nucleus and this radius of electron or the path of electron is r. The distance is r, or we can say that radius of path of this electron is r. So this is the picture. Now electron is moving in this direction. So if you use right hand rule, if you use right hand rule, the field would be coming out. But you miss one thing, that the current, direction of current is always opposite to the flow of electron. So in which direction current is flowing? If electron is moving anti-clockwise, current is flowing clockwise. If electron is moving anti-clockwise, current is flowing clockwise. So if you put this clockwise current at your fingers of your right hand, what would be the direction of magnetic field? Inside the plane of the paper. That's why this field is shown here. Now in the Bohr model, the electron, a negatively charged particle, that we know electron is negatively charged particle, revolves around a positively charged nucleus. So this is positively charged nucleus and electron is revolving around it. And again remember, if electron is moving anti-clockwise, current will move clockwise. So a positively charged nucleus, much as a planet, revolves around the sun. So that we know.